This video will show you how easy it is to create extreme texture using DIY clay-based paint, clay molds, and pigments. It's also a story about a supernatural garage sale.
When you are tired, stand next to you. When you're in the fire,
you may realize this about me already if you've been watching my videos, that I totally believe in the supernatural. There are many things that we can and cannot see.
You believe there's more to this life than what we can see? This is a fun story about answered prayer and a tutorial about how to create texture with DIY clay-based paint. I know this looks kind of gross. It is layered chocolate, and the look that I'm going for is an old piece that has a dark wood finish underneath. So I left the lid off and I'm smearing the paint on to create a heavy texture. So when I blend over it, this dark paint will come through. I'm not sure if it's gonna work, but this is what I had in mind. You should also know that I had been practicing with this piece, so that's why you see all the blended color underneath. I was just kind of using it as a practice canvas until I was ready to actually create something.
I love vintage. I love rusty, crusty, chippy old things. And you most likely do too. For my big 4-0, I saved up my money and I got on a plane and I went to Round Top, Texas.
When you apply DIY paint with a putty knife and you allow it to thicken up and smush it into your furniture like I have just done, you can also make it crack by using a heat gun. DIY paint usually does not bubble when you apply a heat gun. I had put wax on this piece originally, and that's why you're seeing the bubbles. I wanted to create a blended look that has sort of a diagonal line with lighter shades on one half and darker shades on the other. Whenever I set out to blend, I like to use a lot of brushes. I'm using the new brushes from DIY Paint that have super soft bristles and are made for our paint and for blending. I tend to use one brush for one color, another brush for the next color, and a neutral brush to blend the two colors together. You can blend these colors right on your piece and create a third color by moving your brush in different directions, up and down, back and forth, and you kind of pull the paint like taffy, one color into the other.
All these vendors come in, thousands of them, from all over the country, and it is acres and acres of old, rusty, crusty, chippy, peely, vintagey things. I was super excited, but I was also on a tight budget, so by the time I paid for everything, I had maybe $200 spending money.
I want the left side of this piece to be lighter than the right side of this piece, but I don't want it to be a straight up and down line. I want it to be sort of a diagonal. So I'm going in and adding highlights on the left, if that makes sense. And here's a pan of the entire dresser at this point so you can see what I'm talking about. It's purple overall, but the upper left corner is lighter than the bottom. I use a lot of brushes for this process, so I have more control over the color, but you can also use less brushes and stop and clean them. This is our brush cleaner, which works great.
It's not really a junk lover kind of place where you can find bargains. It's more for retail, not resale, but I was still thinking I've got my 200 bucks and I can find some good stuff to bring back to my shop in California and resell it.
Here's a good look at the texture and the deep cracks that I created. I am going back with some warmer colors and I'm just redefining that line. Now I'm working on the darker side of the piece and adding some deeper colors and creating a more definitive diagonal line of depth on the right side.
I walk into the junk gypsy booth. Lots of people who love vintage like white and tan and neutral and white chippy and pale and pastel. I don't. I like the colorful things. And the junk gypsies, they were singing my song. It was color everywhere. It was like being on a movie set. Whimsical, unique, bold, and fun, and loud. And I was just like, yes, these are my people.
My plan is to create a vine of birds and roses that grows diagonally across the dresser. I'm using paper clay. You want to dust your molds with cornstarch and then pull them out immediately. Glue them onto your dresser before they dry so that you have smooth adhesion, because these molds will shrink up and kind of curl a little bit if you allow them to dry and then try to apply them later.
Was just wanting to spend all my money right there, but they didn't have a lot of bargains. The one thing that I really wanted to get that I was obsessed with were the vintage petticoats. They were like $40 each, and that was a quarter of my spending money. If you're not familiar with them, they are these ruffly tulle multi-layered skirts that the women used to wear back in the day when they would square dance, and then when they would twirl around, their skirts would fly up and you would see all the lace.
This is what happens to DIY paint when it dries completely. You can sort of use it like an oil pastel or a pigment stick. You can even soak it back in water and reconstitute it. I'm just using it like a piece of chalk to mark out the lines where I want to apply the molds.
Been obsessed with these things since I was 8 years old. The first time I watched Happy Days, and I watched those girls in the 1950s twirling around and getting dipped, and their skirts came up. What is this? What is this crazy madness? I remember going to my mom and saying, were you alive in the 50s when this happened? I wanted to buy all of them.
I like to use painter's tape to keep all of the molds in place. I use Aileen's tacky glue, which dries very strong but slowly, so I don't want my molds to slide down the dresser while it dries. It takes about 24 hours. This is the part where you trust the process, because it's looking really messy and kind of, not good right now. But it gets better. You just have to keep going. Interject my genius thoughts.
I go through the whole round top. I do find some bargains, but then I go back to the junk gypsy booth and I purchase one petticoat. It was $30. It was pink. It was a lot of money for me, but I get one. Okay, maybe some way I will find more petticoats wholesale somewhere when I get back to California, because all I want to do was just fill my whole store with vintage petticoats.
DIY paint dries flat, chalky, and very porous because of all the clay in it, and this creates the prime surface for our pigments. So if you dip your brush in water and then dip your brush in DIY pigment, the pigment will stick to the end of the brush and you can apply the pigments to the dry paint surface. Do this before you apply any sealer, because the pigment is super easy to blend and create all kinds of depth and interesting looks. Again, it's not looking good right now, but it is gonna get there. Here I'm using the darker green pigment to go in and create more depth and shadows in the low spots of the molds.
I'm back in California and I am on the hunt. This was a lost cause. Garage sales were totally hit and miss. We don't have a lot of old stuff out here. Every Saturday morning when I would go to yard sales, I would say the yard sale prayer. It would go something like this: God, please help me to find some really cool stuff to sell in my store. Let it be affordable. And God, please blind the eyes to all of the other shoppers so that they don't buy the stuff that I need.
I'm using a small artist brush to go in with the dark purple pigment to create more shadows in the low spots where the roses would be. Just like the leaves, I'm using that pigment, using my spray bottle, letting it run, and just creating a variety of color and depth using the pigments.
need. This Saturday morning, I say my usual prayer, but I add on a little something and I say, God, please let me find a whole bunch of vintage petticoats and let it be like $20 for all of them. I see this cool old house. There are yard sale signs and I pull up, I get out of my car and it's vintage everywhere. But the prices are high. And I start talking to the lady. They used to have an antique store, so they know the value. Nothing that I can buy and resell, but I had the faith. I had said the prayer. I'm about to leave. Can I help you find something? Well, you wouldn't happen to have any old vintage petticoats, would you? You
know? Now I'm using our white decrepit dust like a highlighter. This is kind of like using white wax, but you can reactivate it with water. I don't want to put any wax or sealers on at this point because once you do that, the blending stops. So I'm softening the look and adding highlights in the high spots. It's basically white pigment like our other pigments, but you can just soften the look and create more highlights. I said that already, but you can see it's working. Is it working? I think so.
You know what? My friend Bob, he's out getting some coffee right now, but he used to own a vintage clothing store, and I think he does have some of those. His boxes are right over there under that table, and he hasn't unpacked them yet. I don't know when he's coming back. That was all I needed to hear. I know God is going to answer this prayer. I just feel it.
I think I've said this in every video lately, but I like to think of the pigments like the powdered sugar on the donut. So once you get all of your paint blended, you can go in and highlight all the details of your furniture. So I'm going in with some darker colors and just making those little molded areas where the furniture is carved in and out, and all the edges of the drawers where the shadows would normally be, I'm just highlighting those.
And Bob shows up and he's looking hungover and he's got his coffee and he's looking like he had had a wild night. Like, are you Bob? And she's like, yeah. Your friend over there said that you might have some old petticoats. Yeah, I think I do. I think I have some. Hold on a minute. You know, and he's moving really slow and I'm looking at my watch.
At this point, I think I'm done with all the pigments, so I'm going in and I'm using our gold metallic wax on the high spots of all the molds. They say that art is a push and a pull. So what that means to me is you're just constantly creating shadows and depth and pulling out the highlights, and it's a back and forth. And when I get down to this point, I just keep fiddling with it. It's the fun part.
He pulls out this big black trash bag. He looks in it and he's like, yeah, these are them. So I get the bag. If I pull these out, it will be an explosion of lace and color and people will swarm on me like bees on honey. I thought these petticoats were amazing and I didn't want anyone to even know that they were in the bag. I stick my head inside the bag and I'm kind of rummaging around and I see that there's multiples of colorful pink and green and mint and just gorgeousness, and it smells like old, musty, so they're vintage.
You're seeing me do now is add a chunk of that dried up paint to add a little bit of aqua color. I was just curious to see if it would work. Once you spray it with water, it's really easy to blend. Now I'm going in and I'm just shadowing under the molds. I'm adding our pool party pigment. The pigments look really kind of harsh when you first put them on, but you add that water and they blend in beautifully. So this is the part where you need to commit. You need to commit to the fact that you're done. DIY paint is easily reactivated with water for weeks after you apply the paint. But once you put a sealer on, then the blending is over. So you see me applying clear wax to the upper left side of the dresser and dark wax, a mix of dark wax and clear wax, to the lower right side of the dresser.
I lift my head back up and I'm like, Bob, how much for the whole bag? $10. I give him the $10. I get in my car. I start whipping him out and I can't even believe it. He totally answered the yard sale prayer.
Now I'm adding a little bit more white wax to the top. I'm using this in combination with clear wax because our white wax and our dark wax are both very intense. So you can use that clear wax like an eraser or put it underneath those dark and white waxes so that you don't get it too dark or too white. You have more control that way. And I'm wiping back the excess.
It's never too late.
Why would God answer that prayer about a bunch of dusty old pieces of lace skirts? There are many prayers that God hasn't answered. I beg God to save my mom of cancer. He answered that with a no. But I don't think we can look at God like a vending machine. The only thing I really know for sure is that God wants our hearts, and He gets our attention in weird ways, in ways that don't make sense, in ways that are not predictable, in ways that are personal for each one of us.
I was happy with the way that this piece was looking, but I felt like it needed something warm to contrast with the cool blues and the purples. So I went in and applied more pigment powder, and then I put in Spirited, our Bohemian Bright. And at this point, I was super happy with it.
What if we're living in a fantasy? Some world that I could only dream. New colors bursting out of every seam. A hidden land for you and me.
I would like to thank Sandy King, Sarah DePaula, and Jamie Ray Vintage. They provided photos for the B-roll in this video of Round Top, Texas, and the Junk Gypsies, as it's been 17 years since I took that trip. The links to their pages are below.
Sometimes our feet float off the ground.
That is it for this week. Be sure and subscribe because we will have another fun video coming next week, and they may be coming every Friday. Ellie told me not to promise that, but so far we've done it 3 weeks in a row.
To find DIY paint in your area or to sell it in your store, click the link below. And to find all the products used in this video, click the link below. Thanks for watching.
Sing a sad song. To sing a sad song. Yeah. No one. When you get knocked out, you know that you gotta get.
I'm wearing the same coat because it's still cold here. I feel like I can see my breath. So this is my new favorite jacket. I know I wore it in the last video. Hopefully I will not be wearing it in the next video because I'm so ready for spring.